59, 1 and 2. He said, our iniquity and our sin has made God to separate his and to turn his face against us. Therefore, this morning, let's be asking the Lord, please have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, Lord. Any area I have seen, iniquity and our sin has made God to separate his and to turn his face against us. Therefore, this morning, let's be asking the Lord, please have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, Lord. Any area I have sinned against you, Father, have mercy on me. If there is iniquity in me, your coming to service today will just die here, will not be able to go. Because there is nothing that is connecting you between our God because of the sin. Let's begin to ask the God, please have mercy on me. Wash my sins away with the blood of Jesus. Let my sin be washed away right now. That my coming to your presence today will bring out something good. Have mercy on me, Lord. Have mercy on me, Father. Have mercy on me.
Lord, have mercy.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We are still going to pray by asking God's presence. It is by the presence of God, with the presence of God, we can do all things. We have come to this church today to have a sweet moment with God. But without God's presence, being present in our lives and in the church, our coming will be in vain. But I know our coming will not be in vain in Jesus' name. Let's begin to ask God, we ask for your presence. Let your presence fill this place. Let your presence fill my heart. That I will be able to see that which you have for me today. Let your presence be this place. In the book of Genesis 35, verse 2, the Lord declared, said, the Lord was with Joseph. That means the presence of God was with Joseph, and that was why Joseph was able to succeed to become a prime minister in his dream land. Father, I ask for your divine presence today. In my life, your divine presence. Ask for divine presence. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
The presence of God is here already. Get ready for a new turn of miracle.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are still going to pray this morning. We are going to ask God and say, Lord, give me grace to always be a blessing to others. Give me the grace to always be a blessing to others. The life of Joseph in Genesis chapter 39, verse 3, the master of Joseph confirmed that since Joseph came into his house prospered. Things that were not normal in that house before, at the stepping of Joseph, things turned around. He began to succeed. Let's ask for God, make me to be a blessing to someone. Let my life be a blessing to people around the world. Make me an impact, to make an impact in the life of somebody out there, to be a blessing to someone. Grace to be a blessing, Lord, we ask of you today. Grace to be a blessing to nations of the earth. Father, I ask for the grace. We as a church, we ask for the grace in this assembly, Lord, to be a blessing to all that denominations, to be a blessing to men and women out there. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The grace we ask to receive in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are still going to pray. We are going to pray by asking God, say, Lord Jesus, set my soul, my body on fire for you. I want to be on fire for you. Set my bones on fire. When the fire of God is upon you, you begin to see strength begin to happen. Miracles everywhere. In the life of the healing apostle Peter, even the shadow of Peter were healing the sick. People were being saved and delivered with his own shadow alone. Because the fire of God was upon Peter. Lord, set my bones on fire for you. Set my spirit on fire for you. Set my bones on fire. Let my life be a healing to somebody out there. Let my life be on fire. When the life of a man is on fire for God, everything concerning God will be interesting to him. He will be happy to follow to the things of God. Set my bones on fire, Lord. Set my bones on fire today. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Lord will set us on fire for him on today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 28, he said, all things working together for good, for them that love the Lord. On the contrary, those that do not love God, those that hate the Lord, all things will work easier for them. If you hate God, it will work easier. If you love God, it will work together. We are going to be asking Lord God, give me grace to love you more and more as a church. Give me the grace to love you more and more. I want to love you because I want things to go better for me. Grace to love you, Lord. Grace to love you. To love you as never before. Grace to love the church. In the name of Jesus, Lord, give us grace to love you. Give us grace to love you more and more. As you bend on us, Lord, give us the grace to return the love back unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The grace to love God will be seen in the name of Jesus Christ. We are still going to pray and say, Lord, the word of God says that my Father's heart shall be a house for prayer. We are going to be asking of God, this church, this assembly, we submit into thy hand. Let this assembly move from glory to glory. Let it move from fire to fire. Let it be a reference point over to others. Let it contact others to this assembly. Begin to submit this assembly into the hands of God for the power of God to come down. For the glory of God to showcase itself in this assembly. In the name of Jesus, begin to submit this assembly to the hands of God. Father, I submit this church into your hands. I submit this church into the heavenly Lord. Let it be a reference point, O God. A reference point that we connect all our nations of the world unto your presence. In the name of Jesus, let your grace, let your power begin to flow in this assembly. Let your power begin to flow in this assembly. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. One more thing, we are still going to pray and say, Lord, help me to be a problem solver. I discovered in the life of Joseph in Genesis chapter 40, verse 1 to 21. Joseph was a problem solver. The problem he saw for the two prisoners was also the one that brought him out of prison after 2 years. He saw their problem, they had a dream, they were troubled. Joseph noticed their trouble and said, what is your problem? And by the grace of God, he interpreted the dream. One of them remembered him after 2 years. And that one made Joseph to be the prime minister in his own land. Because he was a problem solver. Lord, make me a problem solver to others. Make me a problem solver to others. I told you to pray at this hour. Have the Lord to make you a problem solver. Because I discover as you begin to solve other people's problems, God will be solving your own. As you are solving other people's affairs, God will be stepping into your own. Lord, make me a problem solver this year. Make me a problem solver to the nations. Make me a problem solver to my family. Make me a problem solver to my neighbors. Make me a problem solver, Lord. A problem solver, not a problem creator. A problem solver, not a problem creator. Lord, give me grace to be a problem solver. Joseph solved the problem for the two prisoners. 2 years, because of what he did, God now determined. He was solving the problem for the prisoners. He never knew God would use that one to solve his own problem. Because of that, God brought him out of the day, out of jail, and made him a prime minister. Lord, I want to be a problem solver this year. I want to be a problem solver to the nations of the earth. Just help me, Lord. I need your grace. I need your grace. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. The Lord be hearkening unto our voices today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.